Hello and welcome to Kennesaw Mountain. I'm Ranger Amanda and today I'm going to be talking to you about the geology of the park and its effect on the Battle of Kennesaw Mountain. This is all in honor of today being Geologist Day, which is held every first Sunday of each April. Now I am here on Pigeon Hill, surrounded by a variety of pine trees and hardwood trees, and I'm standing on large boulders, and there's boulders all around me, which is part of the geology here at Kennesaw Mountain. Now, the state of Georgia is made up of five geologic regions, and those geologic regions are the coastal plain, the Piedmont area, the north area is the Blue Ridge Mountains, you have valley and ridges, and then you also have the Appalachian Plateau. And those are all the regions within the state of Georgia. Now the coastal plain is made up of estuaries, mud flats, beaches, and it actually spans from the Georgia coast all the way up to a geologic feature known as the fall line. Now the fall line actually spans from Augusta, Georgia through Macon and on over to Columbus. Then you have the Piedmont region, which is north of that fall line, and it runs all the way up to the Blue Ridge Mountains. Now this is normally rolling terrain with some but hills and valleys as you get closer to the mountain region. Now in the northwest portion of the state, you have the valley and ridges, and that is literally ridges of mountain terrain. It's the westernmost part of the Appalachian Mountains that overlook beautiful lush valleys. In the northeast section of the state, you have the Blue Ridge Mountains. This is part of the Appalachian chain, and it is rounded mountain peaks which span roughly 1600 feet up to 4700 feet above sea level. So you have those beautiful mountain views, and it's known as the Blue Ridge because the beautiful mist that is around that area gives the mountains kind of a bluish hue. Now the smallest geographic region within the state of Georgia is the Appalachian Plateau, and this is in the far northwestern corner as you approach Chattanooga. Now this is an area of beautiful vistas and probably one of the prettiest places in the state, although depending upon where you are, you might have a different viewpoint, and that is perfectly fine. But you have those beautiful vistas that overlook the valleys below. And these are the various geographic regions, and they all have a little bit different in their topography, as well as the types of mountains and hills and rocks that are going to be characteristic for those locations. Now, Kennesaw Mountain National Battlefield Park is located in the Piedmont region. And so we're part of that rolling hills and terrain. The interesting thing about the Piedmont region, especially in this portion, the northern portion of that region, is you have a variety of monognots. Kennesaw Mountain is actually known as a monognot, and that means lonely mountain. So it's not necessarily in a chain itself. You have several different monognots throughout the greater Metro Atlanta area. Of course, Kennesaw Mountain, to our west is Lost Mountain. You also have Sweat and Blackjack Mountains. And then even to our east, a very unique one that's known as Stone Mountain. Now, Kennesaw has metamorphic rock that makes up its geologic features. But over at Stone Mountain, it's a pluton, and I do apologize if I mispronounce that, but it is where an intrusion of magma has come up above the ground and cools down. And so that's why that's that dome shape of rock. It looks vastly different than Kennesaw Mountain, but it is also a lonely mountain all into its own. Now, with all those different terrains, it is going to highly affect how the Union and Confederate forces fought here, but along the entire Atlanta campaign. They're literally going through three different regions. You're going to have them going through the Appalachian Plateau, the Valley and Ridge area, as well as the Piedmont. And the generals, Sherman and Johnston, are going to really have to think about how that's going to affect their movement of their armies and what they need in placement and how they're going to attack. By the time the forces come here to Kennesaw Mountain, Kennesaw is a unique force, and Sherman actually does a frontal attack at this location. The thing is, that's a little bit different, is the Confederates have the high ground here. They have the advantage compared to the Union forces. Of course, being on top of the mountain peak, you can overlook your approaching army. In addition to that, the Union forces are going to have to attack uphill. The Confederate forces are going to be able to control the rail line because with their artillery, they can see where the rail line is going. So they have that advantage. Now, the interesting thing too is we think of Kennesaw as two mountains, but it's actually one with two peaks and the spur. I'm standing on the spur at the south end, which is Pigeon Hill, but then you have the larger peak of Big Kennesaw and the smaller peak of Little Kennesaw. So the Confederate forces have the advantage of being on top of there, as well as other locations to our south. The Union force is actually at a disadvantage. Again, I mentioned that they have to attack uphill, but in addition to that, they're also going to not be able to move their troops in a defensive position, or not defensive, but an attack mode, quite in the more traditional format that they may have on a flatter ground. So they're always at that disadvantage. And you see that with the casualty loss at Cheatham Hill by the Union forces. The Union only was able to break through the Confederate line down around Cobb Farm, where they got around Hood's troops. However, other than that, right here at Kennesaw Mountain and Cheatham Hill, they did not break through that Confederate line. Now, I know that's kind of really quick story about how the geology and the geographic features of Kennesaw really play into that, but how can you help preserve this historic location and this geological location as well? Well, one of those ways is to help us keep it clean and beautiful. And that's, of course, picking up your trash, making sure you deposit it in a trash can when you come to that location, keep it with you until you can do that. Stay on our designated trails, because when you get off the trails, it's going to wear down the grasses and the different lichen and things on the rocks and cause more damage by the erosion that causes, where natural erosion could be a little slower if it's not damaged. And even the park really takes into consideration these safety procedures. If we are putting up a new structure, even digging a hole for a sign, we have to go through very extreme measures and a process in order to make sure we're preserving this location as well. So we can't do it without you. Even things as graffiti on rocks is going to cause damage to our location. And we can't preserve this beautiful, natural, and historic spot without you. We hope you've enjoyed learning a little bit about geology here in Georgia, as well as how it affected the battle here at Kennesaw Mountain. I hope that you enjoyed the program. Please like and subscribe our social media pages, and we hope you will join us again for future Kennesaw Mountain programs. Thanks so much. Bye.